this is an internationally unique site in that the Alpine fault has been exposed naturally through the weather and the slippage, and it's the only place in the world that you can actually see a major plate boundary above the ground. The fault is known to move at more than the speed of sound, about 8 metres sideways and about 3 metres up. Now that amount of movement in one violent action will wreck anything, including us.
What we know about the Alpine Fault is that the last time it produced a big earthquake was in 1717 AD, which is just over 300 years ago. And based on the statistics of this long history of earthquakes on the Alpine Fault, we know that the fault produces earthquakes roughly every 300 years. And so we're now essentially overdue for the next event on the Alpine Fault. The Alpine Fault earthquake is going to produce a surface rupture that's several hundred kilometres long, and the areas that are going to feel the effects the worst are the ones sitting right on or near the Alpine Fault. So the West Coast communities, right from Milford Sound, Haast, the glaciers, all the way up to Hokitika, are really going to feel the worst effects from this. So the thing with the magnitude scale is that it's a logarithmic scale. For example, the difference between the Christchurch earthquake in 2011 and our future Alpine Fault magnitude 8 is actually 1,000 times more seismic energy being produced.
When it moves, this whole range will lift and move. Well, we know it's done it 27 times over the last 8,000 years. The odds are it'll happen again. But you know, if it doesn't, what's wrong with being prepared in case it does?